Welcome to my channel Question Bank. In this video, I am going to explain a special type of problem that is called black box problem from network theory. And I want to explain what are the black box problems. Then some part of the circuit are hidden, which is represented by a box. As we don't know the detailed circuit within the box, it is called a black box. In such problems, more than one parts are granted for access, and the problem is architect within these ports. If we consider a two port network, there is a input and an output port, and the problem regarding two port network is now confined within the two port parameters like Z, Y, T, that is ABCD or hybrid and hybrid parameters. Like two port network, certain port of the circuit is hidden within a box, and only the specification given may be circuit is of resistor, made up of resistor or and. Both resistors and independent sources are only resistors, or nothing is given about that circuit. For simple problems, we have seen till date in many exams, we have to consider the black box to be circuit of resistor and independent sources. Dependent sources cannot be inserted within unknown circuit, and memory elements like capacitor or inductor. Inductor capacitors are not generally used in simple problems. Almost all the networks, there may be used to solve such problems wherever required. The maximum used theorem is Thevenin's theorem, by which we can express the unknown circuit by a single source and a resistor connected in series, where these type of problems are basically asked in engineering services examinations. Mostly asked in engineering services examination, and there may be some visibility in GATE or other exams. I have collected these problems from previous engineering services papers, and here is the problem and its solution. First question: Thevenin equivalent of the network in figure I are 10 volt and 2 ampere. If the resistance of 3 ohm is connected across terminal AB as shown in the figure 2, what are Thevenin's equivalents? Here the previous Thevenin is given this much. If we insert another resistance across the circuit, then what will be the Thevenin equivalent? Then here the voltage was 10 volt. Then if we add another resistance, then the open circuit resistance, I want to clear the screen first. Then if we add another resistance, then 10 volt into 3 by 2 plus 3, that means 6 volt will be appear across this resistor, and this will be the Thevenin voltage for this open circuit. and resistance will be the parallel of 2 and 3, and hence this is 1.2 ohm. This is very easy problem. Next question. As shown in the figure, 1 ohm resistance is connected across source that has a load line V plus I is equal to 100. The current through the resistance is V plus I is equal to 100. When V equal to 0, this is the characteristic equation given. We can consider when V equal to 0, that means I is equal to 100 ampere. That means V equal to 0 means voltage is 0, that is short circuited. It is the short circuited current. And when I is equal to 0, that means open circuited. Current is 0, no current is flowing, that is open circuited. And V will be 100 volt. That means I have now open circuit voltage and short circuit current. I can find out the resistance. And resistance will be 100 by 100, which is equal to 1. And now, as the open circuit voltage is 100 volt, this is the Thevenin equivalent, VTH. This is the Thevenin equivalent. And if I add to the output 1 ohm resistance, then the equivalent circuit will be this one. I have represented the black box here to the Thevenin equivalent, this one, with 100 volt source and a series resistance of 1 ohm. And the current will be 100 by 1 plus 1, which is equal to 50 ampere, and option B is the correct answer. Next question. In the circuit shown below, for different values of R, the values of V and I are given. Other elements remaining the same. When R equal to infinity, V is equal to 5 volt. When R is equal to 0, I is equal to 2.5 ampere. When R is equal to 3 ohm, the value of V is given by. Here, this R is equal to infinity. It indicates the open circuit condition. R is equal to infinity means this is open circuit condition, and open circuit voltage is given to be 5 volt. R is equal to 0 means that is shorted. I is equal to 2.5, that means short circuit current. Then we can represent the circuit as this one. VOC, that is open circuit voltage, is given. ISC, that is short circuit current, is given. Then RTH will be open circuit voltage by short circuit current. Then it will be 2 ohm. And voltage across the load, if R is equal to 3 ohm, as given here, R is equal to 3 ohm, the voltage across 3 ohm will be 5 volt here into 3 by 2 plus 3, that is voltage distribution. Option will be 3 volt, and option C is the correct answer. Next question. When I is equal to 0, first we have to read the question. The voltage current relationship feeding the network N is shown in the figure below. The Thevenin's equivalent of the network N will have VTH and RTH as. Thevenin and Thevenin voltage and Thevenin resistance are asked here. Here the relation is given in this plot. When V is equal to 0, that means here V is equal to 0, I is minus 5, this is the condition. And when I is equal to 0, V is 25. Hence, it is the I is equal to 0, that means open circuited, V is equal to 0, that means short circuited. And same thing here happening, and VTH by ITH, which is equal to 5 ohm. Here this problem is something different. First we have to read the problem. For the circuit as shown below, if E is equal to E1, this one is the E is equal to E1 and I is removed, then V is equal to 5 volt. V is the voltage across this I. If removed, this will be open circuited and the voltage across this one will be 5 volt. If E is equal to 0, this one is the first condition we have to note down. Then the second condition, if E equal to 0 and I is equal to 1 ampere, then V is equal to 5 volt. This is the second condition. And the question asked here is, for E equal to E1 and I is replaced by a resistor 5 ohm, then what will be the voltage V? This is the question asked here. Now we have to, so the solution, now here the black box here given is, this is a resistive circuit. Here resistive circuit, as the output is dependent upon E, and here given different conditions for E, we have to represent resistive circuit as a parallel and a series. That means like this one, we have to represent like this. And we have to find out R1 and R2. First condition, E is equal to E1. First condition, E is equal to E1. I removed, then V is equal to 5 volt. That means open circuit voltage is 5 volt. From this we find that open circuit voltage is 5 volt. That means here the open circuit voltage. Here this circuit will not be present. This part will not be present. Then what will happen? The V voltage will be equal to the voltage across R1, that will be equal to E1 and E. This will be first condition we found. Now when E is equal to 0, second condition, E is equal to 0, I is equal to 1 volt, 1 ampere. E is equal to 0, I is equal to 1 ampere, then we are getting V is equal to 5 volt. E is equal to 0 means that is short circuit condition. And we are getting, if E is equal to 0, that means this one is short circuited. Then what will happen? We can write that V is equal to I, this I, here is the source, this source is shorted, and here is the source I, into R plus 1. Why R plus 1? R2 plus 1, this one is the R2 plus 1. This is the B. As this is sorted, R1 has no value now. As E2 is 0, this is the short-circuited condition, and this one is sorted. This one is sorted. Now, have a look here. V is equal to 5 volt as given. 5 equal to 1 into R2 plus 1, and we are getting R2 is equal to 4 ohm. When I is replaced by 5 ohm, now we have in this circuit I is replaced by 5 ohm. We have to replace this one by 5 ohm. Suppose we have to replace this one, sorry, we have to replace this one by 5 ohm resistance. First choose a color and then here we have to 5 ohm resistance. 5 ohm resistance, then what will happen? When I is replaced by 5 ohm, then what will happen? E1 is equal to R2 plus 1 plus 5 into I2. How this is happening? E1 is equal to, E1 is the voltage across R1, will be equal to voltage across here is the E1. E1 is this much voltage, and this will be equal to the rest of. That means here KVL is applied. Hence, E1 is equal to R2 plus 1 plus 5 into I2. And we are getting I2 is equal to half ampere. And from here, we can get V is equal to the voltage across 5 ohm, which is now here will be half into 5, that means 2.5 volt. This one is something critical, 2.5, that means option B. Next question. In the below shown circuit, if V is equal to 3 volt for E is equal to 1 volt and I equal to 0, and this is the first condition, and this one is the first condition. As I is equal to 0, this is the open circuited condition, and here given is E is equal to 1. For E is equal to 1 volt, V is given 3 volt. That means as this is open circuited, we can take it as V Thevenin. And the second, V is equal to 2 volt for I is equal to 2 ampere and E equal to 0. E equal to 0 means this is, so E is short circuited. E is short circuited and the current I is 2 ampere. And it results V is equal to, V is equal to 2 volt. And here we can get VTH is equal to, that is the Thevenin voltage, VTH is equal to 2 ampere. And E equal to 1 volt and I replaced by here another condition. Another condition here given, E equal to 1 volt and I is replaced by resistance of 2 ohm. I is replaced by resistance of 2 ohm. Then what will happen? V is equal to 3 into 2 by 2 plus 1. This is replaced by 2 ohm. Then the Thevenin voltage, we know that Thevenin voltage we have find out the 3 volt. Hence 3 into 2 by 2 plus 1. And 1 is the Thevenin resistance as we find out from second condition. And now we have applied in third condition and find out the result, that is 2 volt. For the circuit shown below, the black box contains resistors and independent sources only. The current I is 3 ampere and 1.5 ampere for R equal to 0. For R equal to 0, I is 3 ampere, and for R equal to 2 ampere, 2 ohm, current I is 1.5 ampere respectively. For R equal to 1, what is the current? We have to represent the black box with a Thevenin equivalent having VTH and RTH, and here this is for R equal to 0 as here given. I want to clear the screen first. Here for R equal to 0, that means this represents the short circuit condition. For I is equal to 3 ampere, that means short circuit current. For short circuit current is 3 ampere. That means VTH by RTH is equal to 3 ampere as shorted. This one is shorted. If this one is shorted, then VTH by RTH is equal to 3 ampere. Now, if second condition, if R equal to 2 ohm, then I is equal to 1.5 ampere. Then this can be represented by VTH by RTH plus 2. Voltage by total resistance, which is equal to current flowing through them. Then if we solve this one and this one, we are getting RTH is equal to 2 ohm. As RTH equal to 2 ohm, now we can apply VTH equal to 3 into 2 is equal to 6 volt. That means we are getting VTH equal to 6 volt. And when R equal to 1, this one is replaced by 1 ohm, then the current will be 6 by 2 plus 1, 6 by 2 plus 1, which equal to 2 ampere. This is the second next question. Here, Norton equivalent to the network N to the left of AB. To the left of AB is a current source IN is equal to 4 ampere from B to A, from this direction B to A. RN is equal to 2 ohm. RN is equal to 2 ohm. Norton equivalent resistance is 2 ohm. The current through R when it is connected across AB is equal to 2 ampere. What is the value of resistance R? Here is the Norton equivalent circuit, and current will be 4 ampere into 2 by 2 plus R, which is equal to 2 given. And if we solve this one, then we will get R is equal to 2 ohm. This is very simple problem. for network shown as below, when I is equal to 0, V is equal to 20 volt, this one first condition, and when R equal to 0, I equal to 10 ampere. If now R is equal to 3 ohm, what is the value of current I? First, I is equal to 0, that gives V is equal to 20 volt. This is the open circuit condition. R equal to 0 gives I is equal to 10 ampere, that is the short circuit condition. Then OC, that is open circuit condition, we can get from open circuit condition, we can get VTH is equal to 20 volt. And from short circuit current, we can get VTH by ISC, sorry, V open circuited, open circuit voltage by short circuit current as the resistance of Thevenin resistance. And now if R is 3, this is represented by Thevenin resistance and Thevenin resistance and source. And now if R is equal to 3 ohm, then I will be represented as VTH by R plus RTH, which is equal to 20 by 2 plus 3, which is equal to 4 ampere. Next question, the black box N contains resistors and independent sources. If I is equal to 3 ampere and 1.5 ampere, for R equal to 0 and 2 ampere respectively, then what is the value of I for R equal to 1 ohm? R equal to 0 plus 2 ohm. 0 and 2 ohm. The corresponding current is given 3 ampere and 1.5 ampere. For R equal to 2, R equal to 0, I equal to 3 ampere, that means this is short circuit condition. And when R is equal to 2, I is equal to 1.5 ampere, VTH by RTH equal to 3 ampere, this is the short circuited condition, that means VTH is equal to 3 RTH. Now VTH by RTH plus R, as R is not given, R is given 2, R is given 2, RTH we don't know, then VTH by RTH plus 2 is equal to 1.5, and if we solve this, we are getting RTH is equal to 2 ohm, and VTH will be 3 into 2, which is equal to 6 volt. And now, if R is replaced, then the current will be 6 by 2 plus 1, which is equal to 2 ampere. Next question. This question is something different and very big problem, this one. The linear network as shown below has only resistors. This is a resistive network only. If I1 is equal to 8 ampere, I2 is equal to 12 ampere, V is found to be 80 volt. This is the first condition. When V equal to 0, when I1 is equal to minus 8 ampere, and I2 equal to 4 ampere. This is the second condition. When the value of I1 equal to I2 equal to 10 ampere, what will be the V? This is the third condition and the question. We have to solve this one using different theorems. First condition here given, we don't require circuit. Here three ports are given, here is one, here is one, here is one, three ports are given. First condition, I1 is equal to 8 ampere, I2 equal to 12 ampere, which gives V is equal to 80 volt. Second condition, I is equal to minus 8 ampere, I2 equal to 4 ampere gives V equal to 0. And this is the question. First thing, we have to consider output is V, this port is output port. We have considered this port is output port, and this is one input, this is another input. The combination of both the inputs we are getting here is the response. Now we have to apply the superposition principle. Superposition principle, according to superposition principle, we have to keep one source active and all the sources in the circuit to zero and add such responses for all the sources, which will give the actual result at the output port. Hence here response for I1 is equal to, from first condition, I1 is equal to 8 ampere and I2 equal to 0, response for this one at output plus response for I1 equal to 0 and I2 equal to 12 ampere, it will give 80 volt. And from second condition, response for I1 is equal to minus 8 ampere, I2 equal to 0 at I2 equal to 0 plus response for I1 equal to 0, I2 equal to 4 ampere, this gives 0 volt. And if we add the both the conditions, then we get I1 is equal to here plus 8 ampere and here is minus 8 ampere, which is resulting in I1 equal to 0, I2 is 0, and response for I1 equal to 0, I1 equal to 0, hence I1 equal to 0, and I2 here 12 and 4 is getting 16 ampere. And we are getting all, this is all 0, here is 0. That means I1 equal to 0, I2 equal to 16 volt. We can conclude this statement as I1 equal to 0, I2 is equal to 16 ampere, which gives V equal to 80 volt. Then we can, this is the superposition principle. This is the superposition. And here we have to apply homogeneity principle. That means for 16 ampere current, the output is 80 volt, 16 by 8. 16 by 80 is equal to for 10 ampere, that is asked in the question. For 10 ampere, what will be the voltage? Then I have noted it by V1, then V1 will be 50 volt first. That is, for response I1 is equal to 0 and I2 is equal to 16 ampere, voltage V1 will be 50. Sorry, this is not 16, this is 10 ampere. This will be 50 volt V1. Now, subtracting 2 from 1, we have to subtract 2, this is a 2 from 1. What will happen? I1 will be 8 plus 8, that will be 16 ampere, this will be 0, this will be 0, this will be 8 ampere. Now what we are getting here? Here is the 16, here is the 8 ampere. Now response here, what is getting response for I1 is equal to 16 and I2 equal to 0, and response for I1 equal to 0, I2 equal to 8, we are getting 80 volt. If we consider from the previous result, we can calculate for 8 for this one. For only this one, how much will be the output? This will be 40 using homogeneity principle. And if we subtract this result from previous one, then we will get I1 for 16 ampere will be I1 16 ampere and I2 is equal to 0, output will be 40 volt. And using again homogeneity principle, we can calculate output for the I1 value is equal to 10 ampere, is V2 equal to 25 volt. And adding this one, here we are getting for I2 is equal to 10 ampere, and here we are getting I1 is equal to 10 ampere. The response here is 50 volt, here is 25 volt. So total voltage will be 50 plus 25, which is equal to 75 volt. And this is the option C is the correct answer. Next question, the resistance seen from the terminals AB of the device whose characteristic is shown in figure below is, the characteristic is shown below. For here, if we see, for V is equal to 0, I is minus 4. That means V equal to 0 means short circuit. Short circuited current is minus 4, and for I equal to 0, V is 20. That means V open circuited is 20. From this we can calculate the resistance. Resistance is will be 20 by 4, which is equal to 5 ohm. Option D. Last question here. For the circuit shown in the figure below, when voltage E is equal to 10 volt, the current I is 1 ampere. If applied voltage across the terminal CD is 100 volt, the short circuit current flowing through the terminal AB will be. This is E equal to 10 volt, that means which gives I is equal to 1 ampere. That means V input equal to 10 volt, I output equal to 10 ampere. V input equal to how much? For V output equal to 100 volt. Here the reciprocity theorem can be applied, and V input by I output equal to V output by I input. That is 10 by 1 is equal to 100 by I. I is given to be 10 ampere. Hence we can say that in such problems, any circuit theory can be applied. Hence no such predictions can be given to those problems, this type of problems. Hence this is the end of the topic. Thank you for watching up to here.